Hi, I'm Dr. Monica Peake, and I'm a practicing internist in Chicago, Illinois. Welcome to another episode of ACP's Physician-to-Physician Conversation series. In this video, I'll provide practical strategies to make effective flu vaccine recommendations using an evidence-based and time-saving approach. I always wholeheartedly recommend the flu vaccine. I say, hey, it's time for your flu shot. Make a declarative statement because it's a faster way to yes, and it's a time saver, in addition to the fact that it helps instill confidence about the vaccine for that patient and for the public's health. That patient may go home and say, hey, you know, Dr. Peake was really encouraging me to get that vaccine. Perhaps you should go in and see your doctor and get the vaccine too. If, however, I sense that there's some hesitation or some worry or some underlying issues, then I'll pause, take a step back in the conversation, and then gently start having a conversation about what their concerns are. They want to feel validated, and despite my tendency to want to interrupt, the best thing I can do for my patients in that moment is to just listen. And I try and be affirming with my body language and let them know that I am really hearing them. And so I do that by saying, okay, well, let me see if I've heard you correctly. Here's what I think you've told me. And that lets them know that I've been listening, that I have digested it. So I never want to make assumptions on the front end about what those concerns might be based on who I think they are. So I let them tell me what their concerns are and let that be the starting point for the conversation. If they've told me anything that has been incorrect, it's a great opportunity for us to rebalance and level set about things that are actually factual. Many things that people think are true may have a good rational thought process or may have good logic to them. And that is the way that we learn a lot about science. We start out with a hypothesis that sounds good, but then we test it, and we might sometimes find out that that's not the case. I want to make sure that people never feel put down by their thoughts or that I'm dismissing them because they may not be accurate. After the end of the conversation, open it up for concerns. Do you have any questions about anything that we've just said? The primary goal is to create a safe space for these conversations, and I might not get them to yes that day, but as their primary care physician, my goal is ultimately to get them to yes, and it may not be until next week. It may be next season. I want you to know that my job is to take the very best care of you that I can. And I'm going to be able to do that if we have the space and the trust for each other that you can share with me anything at all, and we can make decisions together. And I try to then, in every visit, live by my word. Whenever a patient tells me something that they're doing that I know was a challenge to report to me, no, I did not fill that prescription. No, I have not had my flu shot this season. The first thing I always say is thank you for sharing that with me. I always think about Teddy Roosevelt's quote of that, nobody cares how much you know until they know how much you care. And so I try to lean in with my heart and with love. The bottom line is that for me, getting vaccinated against the flu virus is extremely important. And I try and make sure that every one of my patients has access to the vaccine and that I'm actively promoting it in every encounter during the flu season. That's all we have for today's video, but we'll be back with more vaccine content. Please be sure to like, subscribe, and click on the notification bell to receive updates on when our next video will be.